Hello guys, so today let us start our chapter 3, Snapshot, Ranga's Marriage. So before starting the chapter, let me recapitulate the summary of the chapter so that you can understand it very well. So the summary is like this, like the story, Ranga's Marriage, is based on the rural setting of Hosahalli, a very small village in Mysore. Ranga was a son of an accountant and was the first one to have gone to the city to study. When he returned, all the villagers, they rushed to the house hoping to see a different person who had come after studying in the city. But the villagers are disappointed seeing the same Ranga of flesh and bones. Flesh and bones, here it is an idiom, okay? Same haddi or same maas hum bolte hai na. So this is only to decorate the language, okay? That they found no change in Ranga. Ranga had very clear thoughts about his marriage, but the narrator makes him go against his own ideas and marry Ratna, a girl younger in age. City education was gradually changing the mindset of the people of Hosahalli. Now, let me tell you the theme of the chapter. What is the theme of the chapter? Actually, Ranga's marriage depicts the rural life of a typical Kannad village whose social milieu and ethos are undergoing a rapid change due to increasing influence of English, Western culture and urbanization. The story brings into focus the conflict between the tradition and the modernity and shows how tradition is deep rooted in our culture. It also shows that our elder generation influences the younger generation. Okay, we take their perceptions whether we want or not, it doesn't matter. As it happened in Ranga's case, that he had very clear thoughts about his marriage, but as he was managed in such a way that he had to change his perceptions. Okay, so now let us know about the writer of the chapter. The writer of the chapter is Masthi Venkatesha Iyengar. Okay, Ranga, the accountant's son, is one of the, here again this brief summary has been given, is one of the rare breed among the village. Rare breed, why here rare breed has been used? It doesn't mean that he was a different kind of person. Here it means an uncommon person. Why he was understood an uncommon person? Because according to the villagers, he went to study in the city, and according to them he was a different kind of person. That's why the villagers rushed the house after his return, but they found no change in Ranga. Okay, so rare breed means uncommon. Here it is uncommon among the village folk who has been to the city to pursue his studies, to complete his studies. When he returns to his village from the city of Bangalore, the crowds mill around his house to see whether he has changed or not. His ideas about marriage are quite different. Or are they? Okay, here this is a question that initially he had very clear ideas about his marriage, but till the end of the chapter, was he able to maintain the same ideas or not? So let us see here. As I told you, this chapter typically belongs or typically deals with the arranged marriages, okay, as we believe in the tradition. So Ranga's marriage is typically based on the system of arranged marriage. Okay, why arranged marriage? You know, 3/4 of all Indians, they still prefer arranged marriages. We speak about modernity and about Western culture, but still 75% Indians, they prefer only arranged marriages.
Okay, so here is the view of the this village where about the village the writer is talking about. Okay, this is the village Hauza Hali. Okay, and here some of the very important things about in his memories. He had very sweet memories of some of the things belonged to his village. So this is like mango trees of his village. And here is the creeper. You can see the creeper. See these creepers. Okay, and about these special creepers, he was telling that the leaves were so wide and wide that they could even take their meal on the leaf of that creeper. Okay, so now let us start the chapter reading. So when you see the title, okay, first of all the writer is talking about the title of the chapter, that when you see this title, some of you may ask that why Ranga's marriage. Okay, what special in it? Why not Ranganatha Vivaha or Ranganatha Vijaya? Okay, like why didn't I just mold the title? Why so simple title has been given to the chapter? Okay, so well, yes, I know I could have used some other mouth filling one like Jagannatha Vijaya. Okay, then I could use some decorated and some ornamental title for this chapter, or the Girija Kalyana. Okay, but this is not about the Jagannatha's victory or Girija's wedding. Okay, this is not all about the Girija or Jagannatha. It's about our own Ranga's marriage, and hence no fancy title. See, here our own Ranga's marriage, so it shows that how close the writer was to Ranga. So here he is talking, it shows their personal relations. So Hauza Ali is our village. You must have heard of it. No. So the rhetorical question he is asking, that you must have heard it, शायद आप लोगों ने सुना हो, but then again he himself is giving the answer that no, क्या तुमने नहीं सुना है? So what a pity that I feel pity for you that you haven't even heard the name of our beautiful village, but it is not your fault. Then he is justifying that it's not the reader's fault that if they haven't heard about the village, there is no mention of it in any geography book. Then he is talking about the geography book. You might have seen this. Nowadays we have maps in our Android phones, so we can just find out any village, any address through the map. So in the same way, he is talking about the geography book. Initially at that time they didn't have this maps in Android phones, no? That's why they had geography book, and they could find out whatever place they wanted to. But in that geography book, the mention of Hauza Ali was not given. They did not mention it. So those sahibs in England, okay, here the sahibs has been used for the English people, writing in English, probably do not know that such a place existed. That according to the writer, the English people, they didn't know about the existence of their village, and so make no mention of it. Our own people to forget about it. Even he had no complaint against these English people. In fact, he's saying that just leave the English people. Our English people ko to chodo, Angrezo ko to chodo. Hamare khud ke logo ko ye pata nahi hoga. Wo khud hume bhool gaye. You know how it is. They blindly follow. You know how it is. They are like a flock of sheep. Okay, here who has been compared, like the people who prepare the maps and all, okay, they have been compared here. Okay, so they are, simile has been used here. Okay, like a flock of sheep. So one sheep walks into a pit, agar ek sheep gadde mein gir jati hai, then the rest blindly follow it. Means they don't think think, they don't see that what is going on. Only they just follow whosoever is in front of them. Okay, जो sheep होती हैं वो भेड़ों का झुंड जो होता है वो blindly एक दूसरे को follow करती हैं. वो नहीं देखते कि आगे वाले सामने वाले अगर गड्ढे में गिर गई है तो मैं क्यों गिरूँ. No, they don't think about it. वो ये सोचते हैं कि सामने वाला गिर गया है तो मुझे भी गिरना ही है. So, when both the sahibs in England and our own geographers have not referred to it, you cannot expect the poor, you cannot expect the poor cartographer to remember to put it on the map, can you? Ab wo kehta hai that if, see, our geographers, first of all, the English people, they forgot us, okay? And after that, our own geographers, who belonged to India, they also forgot us. Okay, then how can we expect the poor cartographer? Means they don't even just look at the things. Your poor cartograph, वो उनको बेचारे नहीं कह रहा है कि वो बेचारे हैं, poor cartograph, उनकी तो कोई गलती नहीं है. He is making an irony here. He is, मतलब आलोचना कर रहा है ये उनकी, उनके ऊपर व्यंग्य कर कस रहा है. Okay, he is criticizing the cartographers, the geographers and those English people. They didn't open their eyes, they didn't see what was around them. They just blindly follow one each other. Okay, so how could we expect those cartographers to find out something new? So there is not even the shadow of our village in any map here. Though, like in Hindi we speak that namo nishan nahi hai kisi cheez ka. To wahi hai ki map mein hamare gaon ka kahin namo nishan tak nahi hai. So there is no shadow of our village on any map. Sorry, I started somewhere and then went off in another. So here the writer is apologizing, the writer is mentioning that I wanted to talk about Ranga's marriage but I lost somewhere else. Okay, I lost in my village and why the geographers did not mention, I just lost in that. But now let me change the direction. Okay, if the state of Mysore, so where this Hauza Ali is situated, it is in Mysore. Okay, so if the state in Mysore is Bharat Varsha, okay, so Bharat Varsha, the typical word has been used here, Bharat Varsha, agar Mysore bhi Bharat Varsh mein hai, then what the sweet Karigadabu, this is a sweet, you might have heard about Gujia. You know, this in South India, this is a very, the people, they are fond of this sweet, okay? And you can also find it here in Arguhana also, okay? So, you can find it whenever you'll just, if you haven't tasted it, taste it. It's quite delicious. It's too delicious. So, to festive meal, okay? So, Hauza Ali is to Mysore state what the filling is to the Karigabadu. So here the writer wants to tell the importance of his village. Okay, like the sweet, he has just introduced the sweet Karigadabu. I told you this is called Gujia here in our language. So actually the filling of Gujia, filling of the sweet is very important. Okay, filling means जो इसके अंदर भरा जाता है, जो नारियल या सूजी समवेयर मावा भी यूज़ होता है. सो द फिलिंग ऑफ द स्वीट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द स्वीट. ओके, सो इन द सेम वे ही वॉन्ट्स टू से दैट आर विलेज Hauza Ali इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मैसूर. मैसूर मीन्स दिस इज़ नाउडेज दिस इज़ कॉल्ड कर्नाटका. ओके, सो जैसे कर्नाटका इंडिया के लिए इम्पॉर्टेंट है, उसी तरीके से कर्नाटका के लिए, मैसूर के लिए हमारा जो Hauza Ali वो भी बहुत ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट है. सो व्हाट आई सेड इज़ एब्सोल्यूटली ट्रू. सो जो मैं कह रहा हूँ दैट इज़ ऑफ कोर्स, दैट इज़ ऑल एब्सोल्यूटली ट्रू, देयर इज़ नथिंग लाई इन इट. सो बिलीव मी, आई विल नॉट ऑब्जेक्ट टू यू क्वेश्चनिंग इट, बट आई विल स्टिक to my opinion. Of course, I do not object if you are just questioning on my opinion, but let me make it very clear that I am stick on my opinion. I am not the only one who speaks glowingly of Hoza Ali. Means I'm not the only one who is boasting about Hoza Ali. Except me, there are many, and especially I would like to talk about the doctor. We have a doctor in our place. His name is Gundabatta. Okay, so he agrees with me about the opinion. Means our both opinion of us, though they are same. Okay, so he has been to quite a few places. कुछ जगहों पर वो घूम के भी आए हुए हैं. No, not England. He has not seen the England. Seen England. If anyone asks him whether he has been there, he says no ananya. Like this word is typically is used in Kannada language this is a respectful word. This word is used for the elder one to give him respect. Okay, so he says simply that he has not been there. वो वहाँ पर नहीं गया है. एंड आई हैव लेफ्ट दैट टू यू. और कौन कहता है ये? हु इज सेइंग दैट? दिस डॉक्टर इज सेइंग दैट आई हैव लेफ्ट इट फॉर यू, दैट आई लेफ्ट दैट प्लेस फॉर यू. यू जस्ट गो एंड जस्ट सी इंग्लैंड. आई हैवंट सीन बिकॉज आई हैव लेफ्ट इट फॉर यू. यू जस्ट गो एंड सी. ओके, रनिंग अराउंड लाइक अ फ्ली पास्ट अ डॉग. फ्ली पास्ट अ डॉग, हैव यू सीन अ फ्ली पास्ट अ डॉग? लाइक अ डॉग जब उसको थोड़ी खुजली वगैरह हो जाती है, या फ्ली जो डॉग के ऊपर थोड़े छोटे छोटे या थोड़े से बड़े भी हो जाते हैं, तो उस तरह के इंसेक्ट्स होते हैं. और उन इंसेक्ट से परेशान होकर डॉग क्या करता है, भागता रहता है. सो दैट उसको क्या लगता है, दैट ही वॉन्ट्स टू गेट रिड ऑफ दोज फ्लीज. बट और वो उस चक्कर में वो भागता रहता है. बट अल्टीमेटली वट एज अ रिजल्ट दैट ही कैन नेवर गेट रिड ऑफ दोज फ्लीज, क्योंकि वो डॉग के साथ साथ चलती हैं. सो आई हैव सीन अ फ्यू प्लेसेस. और ये उसने जो है ना अपने लिए कैसे यूज़ किया है कि दैट मैं कोई फ्ली पेस्टर डॉग नहीं हूँ कि इधर उधर भटकता फिर. ऑफकोर्स आई लाइक to visit the places, I like to see the new places, but I'm not a flea pastor dog कि मैं यहाँ वहाँ कहीं भी घूमता फिरूँ. Okay, I have seen a few places in my time, though as a matter of fact he has seen many. Okay, of course I have seen many places in my life, and this is a matter of fact. So up today this is all about this chapter. Okay, and the rest of the chapter we'll do tomorrow.
So guys, this is all for today, and we'll meet tomorrow. Till then, have a nice day, and do your homework very well. I hope you people are doing your homework, and there should be no carelessness in doing homework. Okay, and thank you. Have a nice day.